Dollar Tree, the popular dollar store chain, just announced a huge shift in its pricing model, and it looks like everything from here on out is going to be much more expensive. In fact, earlier this week, Dollar Tree announced that some of its prices would increase by 25 to 50 cents across all of its stores. Things are getting so expensive at Dollar Tree that the stores are actually creating a brand new section within its locations for all products that are $1.50 and up, meaning that not every product at Dollar Tree is going to be a dollar or under anymore. This is Dollar Tree's way of dealing with inflation. Dollar Tree has to make its prices a little bit higher so that way you pay more for its product, and in turn they'll be able to stay in business and pay their employees what they need to. But here's the thing. Dollar Tree is not the only company that's doing this. Businesses across the world and corporations are struggling right now to deal with inflation, as inflation this year alone has risen by 5.4%. But chalking everything up to just inflation is leaving a lot unsaid here. I mean, there is a lot more going on than just inflation with these businesses. So today we're going to talk about exactly why these businesses are raising prices, what that means for you, and what might be coming in the future as far as inflation goes. But before we get into all that, I need you to do me a quick favor and smash that thumbs up button below and hit that little notification bell too. That way, YouTube shows our videos to way more people worldwide, and we can keep making videos just like this one. Thanks for doing that, and now let's break it down. Let's start today by talking about inflation. Inflation is the steady rise in the price of goods and services, and inflation is not going anywhere anytime soon. You see, there are a variety of different factors that affect what the inflation rate is going to be. Some of these factors include supply chain issues, production costs, shipping costs, and of course, labor. And inflation can hit certain industries and an entire economy either separately or all at once. Like, remember at the beginning of the pandemic, a lot of us were fighting over some of these. Now, this was considered as good as gold back then, and the price to get some was astronomical. But what's so special about toilet paper? I mean, it's not like it really changed from 2019 to 2020, or there was some crazy special toilet paper that everybody needed to get. I mean, if they had some guac toilet paper, I'd be in. But the thing you need to note here is that it doesn't matter what the product is or what the service is. If a lot of people want it and there's not a lot of it, that can cause a massive inflation in the price of that object. That means the price of it is going to go way up. Even if nothing has changed fundamentally about that item, like I said, toilet paper is toilet paper. I mean, yeah, you can get some more plies in there, but it's not special by brand. All of it was selling out last year, which means that the demand for it was super high and the supply ended up going very low. This toilet paper phenomenon lasted for quite a long time last year, probably longer than it should. As of right now, though, at least of recording this video, toilet paper prices have returned to normal. That means there is an equal supply as there is demand. When supply and demand has reached an equilibrium, meaning that the supply of something is equal to the number of people that wants to buy it, the prices will reflect that. In this case, the prices of toilet paper went back to normal. Toilet paper companies can now easily restock their shelves, something that they were definitely not able to do when the pandemic first started. So that's how inflation can affect a specific industry. Inflation can also affect an entire economy all at once. The United States is in one of the biggest labor shortages it's ever seen. Like, just driving around my own town, for instance, I can see business after business posting help wanted signs in their front windows and on signs. So with prices rising, millions of jobs available, and economic stimulus finally coming to an end, where are all the people to actually fill all these jobs? Well, this all has to do with inflation too, because as things continue to cost more, that means everybody is going to have to pay more, including corporations, CEOs, bankers, all these people that control businesses across the country. Ultimately, the cost of living is going to go up, which means a lot of people across the country are going to need to be paid more money. And right now you see a ton of businesses, a lot of these places that have help wanted in their windows, they're not paying more money, which means people that were working those positions are not looking for those jobs anymore. They're looking for jobs that can keep up with inflation and actually pay them the cost of living, at least in their area. In this scenario, workers are refusing to work jobs that are not going to pay them what the cost of living is in their area. Instead, they're looking for jobs that are going to pay them more than what inflation has risen by. This is the first thing that affects inflation within an economy. Remember, we started this video with Dollar Tree and Dollar Tree raising prices. Well, ultimately, Dollar Tree and a lot of these other businesses are going to have to raise wages as well if they want to survive. But if Dollar Tree is paying all of its employees more across the country, then it's going to have to charge you more for all of its products. That's why you see a 25 cents to 50 cents increase across the board for all Dollar Tree locations. See, when it comes to inflation and businesses, it's kind of like a rotating wheel. You see, it starts with businesses paying their workers more. That means increasing wages. But if you increase wages, that means you're using more of your revenue. All the revenue is all of the money that a business actually makes. If you're using more revenue to pay your workers more, that means you can't use that revenue to produce more products, and that's the reason you're in business in the first place. And if you can't produce more products, then you can't get revenue. So the solution here is that you increase the product price and you get more money to actually fuel your revenue and kind of supplement for paying your workers more. One thing leads to another, and it ultimately leads to everything costing more. That's not the only reason that Dollar Tree and other stores are beginning to raise their prices this year. Supply chain issues are another huge factor when it comes to inflation. You see, if something is backed up and the supply can't actually get to the consumer, then that means you have less of the supply of something on a shelf. We saw this a ton with the toilet paper phenomenon of 2020. Toilet paper suppliers could not work fast enough to get toilet paper on the shelves. That sent the price of toilet paper way up because demand was way up, and every time they stocked the shelves, it would basically sell out. Toilet paper, though, wasn't the only thing that was affected by massive supply chain issues over the last year or so. Microchips, the things that go in cars and computers, and lumber, the things that we use to build houses and other construction projects, also fell victim to massive supply chain issues. In fact, the price of lumber hit an all-time high just earlier this year. That means for the same lumber, you would pay about 1,600% more in 2021 than you did back in 2019. The microchip shortage is also having a massive effect on the economy as well, because a lot of people can't get new vehicles right now because the microchips are a vital part of building those new vehicles. That means the price of a new vehicle is highly inflated right now. And in fact, this is actually pushing the used car market actually up for the first time in what feels like forever. That's right, in 2021, used vehicles are actually gaining value. This is all because of the microchip shortage and because new vehicles cannot be made right now. Ford and GM recently slashed their expectations for how many vehicles they're going to make, which means a used vehicle is looking pretty good right now. This problem is twofold because factories shut down for several months back in 2020. That meant that companies could not produce any new goods. However, consumers were still buying the same amount of goods, so every time they bought something new, those products were becoming more rare and more rare, kind of like toilet paper. Eventually, though, companies were able to begin manufacturing products again. But when they started manufacturing new products, they were kind of just meeting back where they left off. In other words, suppliers were massively behind, and they're still behind even to this day, and production of some items is still very far behind. Like, for instance, I moved into a new place back in 2020, so I needed some new furniture because I didn't have any. So I went to my local furniture store and I placed an order. Now, this was at the height of the pandemic back in May or June of last year, and the problem was, I never ended up getting that furniture. Everybody's orders in the store were completely stopped, essentially because all the factories, again, were shut down. No employees were working, and when they finally did start working, they had thousands of orders backlogged that they needed to start first, and mine was way down on the list. So will inflation just continue to rise forever, and will Dollar Tree and a lot of these other companies and corporations just continue to raise their prices? Well, one thing I can for sure say is that yes, inflation will continue to rise. Typically, though, inflation only rises at a rate of around 2 to 3%. That would be considered normal, but like I said at the beginning of this video, inflation in 2021 and a little bit in 2020 rose by around 5.4%. That's definitely unusual. But inflation like this in the United States has happened before. Like back in 1976, the average inflation rate was around 5.74%, and in 1980, the inflation rate was around 13%. It took a few years, but after that point, it eventually plummeted back down by 1983 and was hitting normal rates again. So again, the question is, will this inflation be around forever? Well, eventually, price increases in the United States will have to stop. As you can see, Dollar Tree has only increased its prices by around 25 cents to 50 cents for now. Eventually, though, if they were to increase their prices by $5, $6, $7, people would stop shopping at Dollar Tree. They couldn't afford it. Or they just simply wouldn't want to pay that for the items that Dollar Tree has. So if Dollar Tree wants to survive, at the end of the day, they have to make products that people want to buy. And part of making products that people want to buy is pricing them appropriately. We're seeing this right now in the housing market. Over the last year or so, housing prices have boomed to new record highs. But the problem is right now is they may be getting just a bit too high. Buyers are not purchasing as many houses as they were before, so sellers are going to have to adjust prices so that buyers will come back in. So everything in our economy is getting a bit more expensive, but what you have to know is that everything will eventually adjust if our economy wants to continue living. That means businesses, corporations, stores, they will all have to adjust with production, costs, or wage changes in order to survive as well. And it looks like experts are predicting this level of inflation could last until at least 2023. But that's not set in stone, and a lot of things could happen before that year. And while the world may adjust, it'll only adjust to meet inflation. It won't actually be beating it here, so anything that companies and businesses do, they're not going to be doing to actually beat inflation, especially on your behalf. That means all the pay that you'll be getting, even though you may get a pay increase, it'll just be to meet inflation. You're not actually making any more money because everything around you costs more. If you want to learn the best ways to actually beat inflation, that does not require you to ask your boss for a raise. Our team wrote an article on exactly that over on theminoritymindset.com, and I'll link it for you in the description below. But what do you think about all of these price increases that are happening all around the country? Do you think Dollar Tree and these other businesses should be focusing on paying their workers first or raising prices first? In addition, what are your thoughts on this current inflation rate? Do you think that it's actually going to last until 2023 and beyond, like some experts believe? Or do you think inflation doesn't really matter and it's going to lower sometime soon? I want to hear from you, so drop your thoughts below in the comment section before you go. Thank you so much for watching today's business and financial news breakdown. If you like this video, make sure to hit that subscribe button below and share with a fellow money mind who just does not know a lot about inflation or maybe didn't know a lot of the stuff in this video. Keep hustling, money minds, and I'll see you all in the next one.